Here we go, we're still here now. We're here, you finished bring it back to Malachi, read that verse on the ninth verse.
Malachi 1 and 9, and now I pray you, beseech the Most High that he will be gracious unto us.
That's what we need to do, man. Pray to the Heavenly Father that he's going to be gracious unto us. Pray to the Heavenly Father that he's going to give us a play. What? Give me that Luke 18 and 1 out, because brothers act like it's, like, I know how this thing is, man. Years ago, before the Lord got me into this vibration, I never prayed. I never ever prayed in my life. If I prayed, I didn't know what I was doing. Now the Lord put me into this door, tell me I read the Bible, read this part, read that part, and say, well, you gotta pray, man. You gotta pray. Read it out.
Luke 18 and 1. And he spake a parable unto them, to this end, that men ought always to pray,
right,
and not to faint.
Men ought always to pray and not to faint. Men ought always to pray and not to faint. Anyone ever? Give me this, Wisdom of Solomon 13:1. Read on.
Malachi 1 and 9. And now I pray you, beseech the Most High that he will be gracious unto us. This hath been by your means. Will he regard your person, saith the Lord of hosts?
This hath been by our means. We only here because of our own vibrations. For now, you give me Wisdom of Solomon 13:1. Give me Isaiah, Jeremiah 26:12.
Wisdom of Solomon 13, verse 1. Surely vain are all men by nature, who are ignorant of the Most High, and could not out of the good things that I see know him that is.
That's a big vibration. Let us stand this group as we come out the street, as we bring these scriptures out to the public. We bring these scriptures out to the public. Understand that man, all men, they're supposed to know the Heavenly Father, man. He's supposed to know what the Heavenly Father's all about. He's supposed to know what he requires. He's supposed to know what it takes so you get salvation for your souls, man. Read that again.
Wisdom of Solomon 13, verse 1. Surely, vain are all men by nature.
Surely, worthless. Worthless are all men by nature.
Who are ignorant of the Most High.
Who are ignorant of the Most High. They don't know about the Heavenly Father. They're ignorant of the Father. They're ignorant of this group, man. The Lord called them vain. Or worthless, read on.
They could not out of the good things that I see.
They can't do it out of the good things that I see. They can't see the beautiful sky, the trees, and feel the air, and see all the creations from the Heavenly Father.
Know him that is, neither by considering the works, did they acknowledge the work master.
They didn't even consider it and acknowledge the work master. The work master is the Heavenly Father, man. Surely vain are all men who are ignorant of the Heavenly Father. They're worthless. What does the Most High have to do with them, man? What is he going to do with you? He got something set up here, man, and he needs fuel for the fire. He going to make sure he burns men and women in the fire. All those brothers and sisters, men and women who don't know the Heavenly Father. They don't care for him and don't want to know him. That's what they got covered. Show what you got out.
Jeremiah 26 and 12. Then spake Jeremiah to all the friends and all the people, saying, the Lord sent me to prophesy against this house,
right,
and against this city, all the words that ye have heard.
Check that out, huh? The Lord sent us, man. He said to bring it out. He said, sent us to come out here in the street and bring out all these words, prophesy against this city, prophesy against this country, prophesy about the end days. All these words that you've heard, that's what the Most High said, bring it out. Read on.
Jeremiah 26:13. Therefore now, amend your ways, and your doings, and obey the voice of the Lord your power.
Amend your ways, and your doings. Change your ways, and your doings, man. And obey the voice of the Heavenly Father. Read on.
And the Lord will repent. And the Lord will repent him of the evil that he was pronounced against you.
Right, and the Lord said he's going to repent of the evil that he pronounced against us, man. If we amend our ways, if we turn it around, change the vibration, turn it around. Stop going left and go right. Righteousness, right works, the thing that's right. Read it.
Jeremiah 26 and 14. As for me, behold, I am your hand. I am in your hand. Do with me. as seemeth good in me unto you.
That's how this thing goes, like scripture say. As for me, as for us, we out here in everybody's hands, whatever how this thing goes. We on the front line. They can deal with us like they feel pleased. But we're not worried about a thing. Let me tell you why we're not worried about a thing. Psalms 34:7. Read it out.
Jeremiah 26:15. But know ye for certain that if ye put me to death, ye should surely bring innocent blood upon yourselves, and upon this city, and upon the inhabitants thereof. For of a truth, the Lord has sent me unto you to speak all these words in your ears.
Right, that's how this thing go, man. It's a true thing. The Lord said this, set us up. He told us to speak these words. Don't hold nothing back, man. Don't hold nothing back.
Psalms 34:7. The angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him, and delivereth them.
And delivereth them, man. He encampeth round about them that fear him, and he delivers them. He gives them the place so they can keep pumping his word. Read it.
Jeremiah 26:16. Then said the princes and all the people unto the priests, and to all the prophets, this man is not worthy to die, for he has spoken to us in the name of the Lord our power. Then rose up certain of the elders of the land, back to all the assembly of the people, saying, Micah the Moreshite prophesied in the day of Hezekiah, king of Judah, and spake to all the people of Judah, saying, Thus saith the Lord of hosts, Zion shall be plowed like a field, and Jerusalem shall become heaps, and the mountain of the house, the high place of a forest, did Hezekiah, king of Judah, in order to put him, put him to death at all.
Did they put him to death at all? Listen, this brother here came and prophesied against the city, and prophesied how it's going to come down to the ground, and they didn't touch him. Read on.
Jeremiah 26:19. Did Hezekiah, king of Judah, and all Judah put him to death? Did he not fear the Lord, and besought the Lord, and the Lord repent to him of the evil which he had pronounced against them?
Right.
Thus might we procure great evil against our soul.
That's how we're going to get this thing away from us, man. The destruction that's coming down. The destruction that's coming down to the earth, the whole earth, and it's coming to America. So how are we going to save ourselves, man? How are we going to save ourselves? We got to acknowledge this word and turn our lives around. Amend your ways.